In Jesus' name we pray.
Ni oruko Jesu ni agbadura.
Father, we thank you very much for our study tonight.
Baba wa dupe lowo yin lopolopo fun ikeko wa ti ale yi.
We are grateful, O Lord, for the privilege of granting us the anointing, granting us enlightenment, granting us inspiration as we look at your word, and your spirit helps us to study the word.
Adupe lowo yin Olorun fun anfani ti e bi fun wa. Nipa pe e fun wa ni ifami ororo yan, a fun wa ni oju ti inu ati imoye gege bi a tin ko oro yin.
We are praying, O Lord, that your spirit will be mightily present tonight, and you help every one of us to discover the deep things in your truth, in Jesus' name.
Agbadura Oluwa wi pe emi yin yo so kale pelu agbara lale yi, e o si ran olukuluko wa lowo lati mo awon ohun ijele lati nu otito oro yin ni oruko Jesu.
We pray that phrase after phrase, sentence after sentence, you will enlighten us, you will increase our faith, you'll energize our faith and make us to walk in victory just like these people we're reading about, in Jesus' name.
Oluwa ngbadura pe lati ese le ese lati na gbolohun sinu gbolohun Oluwa eran wa lowo lati le je pe oju oye wa yo la ki awa ko ba le rin ni igbagbo bi awon eyan ti segun ki awa na ko le segun ni oruko Jesu.
We pray, O Lord, that you reach out to every heart today and so increase our faith that we'll be able to do exploits for you.
An gbadura pe ki e ba gbogbo kan soro ni asale yi to be ge ti a o le ni igbagbo ki a le se gudugudu meje yaya mefa fun yin ni oruko Jesu.
We thank you because we know you have answered.
Adupe lowo yin tori pe a mo pe ti dahun.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Ni oruko Jesu ni agbadura.
We come once again to study the word of God together tonight.
Lekan si lale atopejopo lati ko oro Olorun papo.
I'm grateful to the Lord that you have been able to make it, even though we know the conditions around us in the city.
Mo fi ope fun Olorun pe e le wa niti pe bi o ti le je pe arin to gode kan layika wa sibe to wa.
In Hebrews chapter 11,
ninu Hebrew ori kokan la,
we're looking at it from verse 33.
Awo lati ese iketale lo.
And as you look at these two verses we're looking at tonight,
they are saying wa we se meji ti an gbe yewo la
le. That is verse 33 and verse 34.
Iyen ni ese iketale logbon ati ikerin
le logbon. Loaded with meaning.
Opolopo itumo lo wa ninu.
They are loaded with real things that a believer should dig into and explore and bring out something that at the end of the study, by the grace of God, you and I will never be the same again, in Jesus' name.
Opolopo isura lo farase sinu awon ese mejeji to je ki gbogbo nigbagbo ki won sa ipa won ki won lakaka lati wa awajinle lati ri awon isura be to ba je pe leyin ipade yi emi ati iwo ko se nikan ninu wa ti o ri bakan na mo ni oruko Jesu.
We were still talking about faith.
Nipa igbagbo la sin so nipa
re. And it appears that this subject of faith is so broad, is so wide, is so deep, is so high, it's inexhaustible.
Oro nipa igbagbo yi ti a ba wo o dabi eni pe o ga o jinle o gboro o je agbon gbe alagbalugbu omi okun.
In fact, as you look at all the things you are called upon to do as an individual, as a family man, a family woman, as a worker in the church, as just a citizen in the kingdom of God, there is nothing you can do victoriously, successfully without this great faith in your heart.
Bi o se wo ohun ti Olorun n pe wa lati wa se ninu ogba ijara re, gẹgẹ bi osise, gẹgẹ bi okunrin tabi gẹgẹ bi obinrin, gẹgẹ bi omo ibile ninu ijoba na, ko si ohun kan ti o le se ninu ijoba na ti o mo yan lori lai je pe o ni iru igbagbo ti a n ko nipa re.
And what we're looking at today is talking about active faith, dynamic faith.
Ohun ti a si n ko nipa re loni o n so nipa igbagbo to n sise, igbagbo to lagbara.
It is not a kind of faith that is quiet and silent and passive.
Ki se ri igbagbo to n pa roro, to n kawo gbera, ti
ki si n kankan. Just reading the verses alone without even making any explanation.
Iwo na ti le wo ta ba ka awon ese ilasan lai ti e salaye kankan rara.
In verse 33, who through faith subdued kingdoms, wrought righteousness, obtained promises, stopped the mouths of lions.
Ese iketale ni ogbon awon eni nipase igbagbo ti won segun ile oba ti won sise ododo ti won gba ileri ti won da awon kini lenu.
Quench the violence of fire, escape the edge of the sword, out of weakness were made strong, once valiant in fight, turn to flight the armies of the aliens.
Ti won pa agbara ina, ti won bo lowo oju ida, ti a so di alagbara ninu ailera, ti wa di akoni ni ija won le ogun awon ajoje sa.
Something we notice in the faith we're reading about,
o kan wa ta fi yesi ninu igbagbo ti an ka nipa re,
is that this is real faith in the Lord.
Elei gan ni ojulowo igbagbo ninu Oluwa.
This real faith we're talking about in the Lord links you up with the Almighty who cannot fail.
Igbagbo to je ojulowo ta n so nipa re oni yo so apo mo Olorun Olodumare ti olekun.
This faith makes you to draw the resources of heaven here on earth and to find the material on earth with the weapons of heaven.
Igbagbo ti an so nipa re lo dabi gogo ti a fi n fa gbogbo orisun isura orun wa sinu aye yi.
It is like the Lord is calling you by his side and he's saying, I created the world by my power, I divided the Red Sea by my power, I removed those mountains by my power, I removed the Jericho walls by my power, come and I will give you a little bit of that, a little bit of my divine ability. I pass this through you, you believe in the Lord, and then you are able to do what the Lord himself was doing.
Se lo dabi ani pe Olorun pe o si egbe kan o ni ko sumo to si ohun pe ma fiyesi emi ni eleda orun won aye ki se be nikan mo poko paniya o di Jericho emi ni mo wo gbogbo edena ati oke to wa lona awon Israel mo wo pale nitori na sumo to si ni ko gba ninu agbara na ko le di asegun.
And the faith we are talking about is a divinely given faith.
O ji gbagbo ta so nipa re o je ti a fi fun latoke wa,
divinely imparted faith.
Igbagbo ti a fi fun ni latoke wa,
it is a gift from the Lord.
O je ebo lati odo
Oluwa. It is not of yourselves, let anybody show boast.
Ki se nipa ti enikeni ki enikeni
ko mo ba fun. Has given you that gift as a faith, then he energizes, he sustains, he increases that faith in your life.
Lẹ́yìn ìgbà tí Ọlọ́run bá fi irú ìgbàgbọ́ ìjínkì rẹ kò ní fi sílẹ̀ níbẹ̀ nìkan, á fún lágbára, á fún lókun, á sọ di alágbára nípasẹ̀ rẹ.
And you recognize the presence of that faith because it produces something that mere human nature, human ability cannot produce.
Nígbà tí ìgbàgbọ́ ìbá wọnú ayé rẹ, wà á nímọ̀ lára rẹ torí pé ohun tí ẹ̀dá ènìyàn nípa tara ò lè.
You see the things I read to you.
Orí nkan ti mo ka fun o.
You see the various things that I mentioned that faith accomplished.
Orí àwọn nkan ti a ka pe igbagbo se nibe.
We can put the title of the message tonight in various ways.
Orísirísi ọ̀nà ni a le pe akori ẹ̀kọ́ ti a sàlẹ̀ yìí.
We can call it the exploits of faith.
A le pe ni iṣẹ́ ìyanu nípa
igbagbo. We can call it the achievements of faith.
A le sọ nípa àṣeyọrí igbagbo.
But tonight we're using the title the spectacular acts of faith.
Ṣùgbọ́n lálẹ́ yìí a wá ń pè ní àwọn ìṣẹ̀lẹ̀ ìyanu nípasẹ̀ igbagbo.
You know when I study the Bible.
Oh man, nígbà tí mo bá kọ́ Bíbélì.
I try to take all the phrases and all the sentences and all the words one by one and examine and analyze everything and see how you can compare it with other parts of Scripture.
Ohun tí mo máa ń ṣe ni pé máa wo àwọn ẹsẹ̀ kọ̀ọ̀kan gbólóhùn kọ̀ọ̀kan tí ó jáde nínú àwọn ibi tí mo bá ń kà yìí, máa wá mọ́ wọn, máa mọ́ gbà yẹ́bẹ́yẹ́bẹ́ láti fi wé orí kan sí orí kejì.
And then as I looked at these two verses, it interested me that there are 9 exploits of faith that I mentioned.
Bí mo se wa n wo àwọn ẹsẹ méjèèjì tí a n kà nípa rẹ, mo wá sí àkíyèsí pé àwọn ìṣẹ̀lẹ̀ ìyanu nípa ìgbàgbọ́ mẹ́sàn ló wà níbẹ̀.
Number one, they subdued kingdoms.
Àkọ́kọ́ ni pé wọ́n ṣẹ́gun ilé ọba.
Number two, they wrought righteousness.
Èkejì ni pé wọ́n ṣiṣẹ́ òdodo.
Number three, they obtained the promises.
Ìkẹta, wọ́n gba àwọn ìlérí.
Number four, they stopped the mouth of lions.
Ẹ̀kẹrin, wọ́n dí àwọn kìnìún ní ẹnu.
Number five, they quenched the violence of fire.
Ẹ̀karùn-ún, wọ́n pa agbára iná.
And number six, they escaped the edge of the sword.
Ìkẹfà, wọ́n bọ́ lọ́wọ́ ojú idà.
Number seven, out of weakness they were made strong.
Èkeje ni pé wọ́n di alágbára nínú àìlera.
Number eight, they waxed valiant in fight.
Ẹ̀kẹjọ, wọ́n di akọni nínú ìjà.
Number nine, they turned to fly the armies of the aliens.
Ìkẹsàn-án ni pé wọ́n lé ogun àwọn àjèjì sá.
And then as you look at your New Testament.
Bí o ṣe ń wo Májẹ̀mú tuntun.
And you look at Galatians chapter 5.
Bí o ṣe ń wo Galatians orí karùn-ún.
And then it talks about the fruit of the spirit.
Eléyìí sọ nípa àwọn èso
ti ẹ̀mí. Then you count the fruit that is mentioned there.
Tó bá wá kà wọ́n lẹ́yọ kọ̀ọ̀kan àwọn èso wọ̀nyí.
And you find 9-fold fruit of the spirit.
Wà á rí èso mẹ́sàn-án tí ó jẹ́ aládìpọ̀.
Number one, love.
Àkọ́kọ́ ni ìfẹ́.
Two is joy.
Èkejì ayọ̀.
Three is peace.
Ẹ̀kẹta àlàáfíà.
Four is long suffering.
Ìkẹrin ìpamọ́ra.
Five is gentleness.
Ìkarùn-ún ni ìwà pẹ̀lẹ́.
Six is goodness.
Ìkẹfà ni sóore.
Seven is faith.
Ìkeje ni ìgbàgbọ́.
Eight is meekness.
Ìkẹjọ ni ìwà
tútù. Nine, temperance.
Ìkẹsàn ni ìkóra ẹni níjàánu.
And there's something that occurs to you immediately.
Ohun kan ni ó wà sínú ọpọlọ rẹ lẹ́sẹ̀kẹsẹ̀
bẹ́ẹ̀. That as you have the 9-fold fruit of the spirit, so you have these 9 exploits, achievements, supernatural acts of faith.
Bébí a ṣe ní èso aládìpọ̀ ti ẹ̀mí mẹ́sàn-án, bẹ́ẹ̀ ni a ní àwọn iṣẹ́ ìyanu nípasẹ̀ ìgbàgbọ́ mẹ́sàn-án yìí.
It is telling you there is a connection between faith and the spirit.
Eléyìí wá fi yọ pé àṣepọ̀ kan bẹ láàrin ìgbàgbọ́ àti ẹ̀mí.
The more you're full of the spirit of God.
Bó o bá ti ń kún fún ẹ̀mí Ọlọ́run.
The more you are energized of the Spirit of God, the more you are saturated with the Spirit of God, you see that Spirit is from the very throne of God. You know, the Father, the Son, the Holy Ghost. And since faith is a gift,
if
this is your life, that is the Holy Ghost, and it brings faith into your heart, into your life. And then
it's
a turn on to 1 Corinthians chapter 12. And you're looking at the gifts of the Spirit. We're talking about the fruit of the Spirit. Now we're talking about the gifts of the Spirit. And you count all the things that are written there. You'll find once again there are 9 gifts of the Spirit mentioned there. The Spirit of God operating in a dynamic, in an active way. And over there we have number 1, the word of wisdom. Number 2, the word of knowledge. Number 3, faith. And that is miracle producing faith. That is the kind of faith that is supernatural. That is the kind of faith that is so strong, nothing can withstand it and nothing can confront it. Number 4, the gifts of healing. Number
5,
the workings of miracles. Number 6, prophecy. Number 7, discerning of spirits. Number
8,
the diverse kinds of tongues. And number 9, the interpretation of tongues. Again, once again, you ask yourself, as you look at all these exploits of faith, and you see they are the products of the Spirit of God in the life of a man or of a woman, it is the Lord looking at the faith in your life and taking that faith and making use of it to do exploits to the glory of God.
Now
supernatural spectacular acts of faith,
9
full fruit of the Spirit,
9
gifts of the Spirit, and the Lord working mightily in your life, producing unconquerable, that is a kind of faith that cannot be conquered in your life. And then your life is full of supernatural achievements, spectacular acts of faith by the Spirit of God. And we're talking about these kind of dynamic exploits which are so much through life. These things are happening, it turns you to another man. You are not the weak person you used to be.
And so nipa igbagbo yi ti o ma sise ninu aye re to je pe aye igbe aye re pada to je pe oni je alaare bo ti wa tele mo.
Tonight this faith must increase in you.
Lale igbagbo igbodo dagba nu
re
o ti wa nu re
na, but we're going to blow it with the fan of heaven. We're going to put fire within it, and you are going to make it work. Exploits of faith, supernatural acts of faith will be in your life, evident, visible in every one of our lives in Jesus' name.
Lale abebe orun a o fi fe ategun sinu re lo le to je pe agbara olorun yo ma sise agba yanu ninu aye re nipasẹ igbagbo yi.
As you will expect, since there are 9 of them,
nibi o se reti bi o se je pe mesan ni won,
we're looking at them in groups of 3, 3, 3, 3.
Awo won ni onipin meta, iyen ni pe meta meta meta.
And so that has made us to divide the study into 3 parts.
Iyen lo wa je ki a pe eko na si pa meta.
Number 1, promises claimed by strong faith.
Akoko ni fifi igbagbo to lagbara gba awon ileri.
Number 2, possibilities of supernatural faith.
Ekeji ni awon ti igbagbo atoke wa le se.
Number 3, power of steady stable faith.
Eketa ni
I want you to look at number 1, the promises that are claimed by strong faith. The Bible talks about different kinds of faith.
But
there was a time that Jesus was looking at his disciples and he said, why is it you have no faith? Another time he looked at those disciples, one of them, and he said, ye of little faith.
And then you
remember the centurion, you remember that woman that came to the Lord, and Jesus said, great is your faith.
O lati balogun orun ati obirin to to Jesus wa ni ti Jesus pe ti tobi ni igbagbo re.
So there is no faith, there is little faith, there is great faith.
Nitori na ko si gbagbo igbapo kekere ati igbagbo
la. Do you remember that Jesus Christ, in talking to the woman that came to him and was weeping and wiping the tears up, Jesus said, thy faith has saved thee, saving faith.
O ti rati obirin to to Jesus Oluwa wa to nso ku to nfi omi je re nu lara ti Jesus so wi pe
You remember when Jesus said, if you have faith as a grain of mustard seed, ye shall not only do this which I have done, you will say unto this mountain, be thou removed, and it shall be removed, nothing shall be impossible unto you. That's living faith.
There is a state of little faith.
There is a state of great faith.
Ipati igbagbo nla wa.
And there is also a state where the Lord is saying that you have saving faith.
Igbagbo kan wa ti Oluwa yo so pe o ni igbagbo
tun da ni la. There is another faith that is living faith.
Igbagbo kan tun wa to je igbagbo to wa lari.
There is something that the Bible calls strong faith.
O kan tun wa wa ti Bibeli pe ni igbagbo to lagbara.
Being strong in faith is staggered not at the promise of God through unbelief.
O le ni igbagbo ko fi iye meji pe esa igbagbo
sa igbagbo. He was so strong in faith he believed that what the Lord has promised, he's able to do, he's able to perform.
O le ni igbagbo to bege to gba Olorun gbo pe ohun ti Olorun ba se le ri Olorun le se.
And so we're looking at these people we have read about. They manifested strong faith and they claimed the promises of the Lord.
Nitori na an wa awon eniyan ti a ti ka nipa won yi ti won fi igbagbo to lagbara han ti won si bori.
We were examining the first three.
Awo meta akoko.
Look at it once again, Hebrews chapter 11 verse 33.
Iwo tun wo lekan si Eberu ori kokan lese iketa ni
lojo. Through faith, number 1, subdued king. Number 2, wrought righteousness. Number 3, obtained promises.
Awon ni nipase igbagbo akoko ti won segun ile oba ekeji ti won sise ododo eketa ti won gba ileri.
Once again, I want you to understand that when faith is present, you cannot conquer that faith and you cannot conquer the possessor of that faith.
Mo fe ran leti lekan si wipe nibi kibi ti igbagbo ba wa a ki segun tabi ka bori igbagbo yen eni to tun wa ni igbagbo yen gan ko se to le bori re.
Number 1, it talks about the fact that they conquered kingdoms.
Akoko ti o so nipa re ni pe won segun ile oba.
If you look at 2 Samuel chapter 5.
To ba wo Samuel keje ori karun.
Of course there are many parts you can refer to in the Bible.
Awon ebi pupo lo le toka si ninu Bibeli.
And you will find the people that through faith they were so dynamic in their lives, they didn't take the back bench, they marched forward and they confronted the enemy and they subdued the kingdom.
Ti o ba wo won dara dara wa si alabapade awon onigbagbo to lagbara ti won ko kawo gbera tabi ki won ko joko sowo eyin sugbon ti won gba ile oba.
And here we are now reading 2 Samuel chapter 5, reading from verse 22.
Ni ni awon ka Samuel keje ori karun ese keje le logun.
It says very clearly there, and the Philistines came up yet again and spread themselves in the valley of Rephaim.
Awon Philistines tun goke wa won si tun tan ara won kale si afonifoji Rephaimu.
And David inquired of the Lord and said, David inquired of the Lord and he said, thou shalt not go up, but fetch a compass behind them and come upon them over against the mulberry trees.
David sibere lowo Oluwa o si pe ma se goke lo sugbon bu won leyin ki o si kolu won niwaju awon igi baka.
And let it be when thou hearest the sound of it going in the tops of the mulberry trees, that then thou shalt bestir thyself.
Yo si se nigba ti iwo ba gbo iro ese lori awon igi baka na nigba na ni iwo si yara.
For then shall the Lord go up before thee and smite the host of the Philistines.
Nitori pe nigba na ni Oluwa yo jade lo siwa niwaju re lati ko lu ogun awon
Philistines. There you see the Philistines opposing the children of Israel, they were confronting them.
Ni ni ari awon Philistines to ngbogun ti awon ma Israeli.
And David did not want to depend upon his own strength.
David o wa fe gbekele agbara ara re.
Because he knew that supernatural sin can only be done by supernatural power.
Tori pe oyeye gbangba wi pe ohun to ju agbara eda lo o le sele nigba ti agbara to
ti da lo ba wole. The problems that will make the men of great energy, the men of great ability to fall flat on their faces.
Oyeye gbangba wi pe awon wahala kan wa to je pe awon akikanju eniyan alagbara ninu aye iru wahala be yo mu won lo.
He knew that there are problems that can only be overcome by faith in God, by the power of the Spirit of God.
O mo pe awon wahala kan wa to je pe nipa igbagbo ninu Olorun ati emi Olorun nikan ni a fi le se
so he went, he asked the Lord.
O wa to Oluwa lo lati bere lo
Oluwa. And the Lord told him, he said, don't go up yet.
Olorun wa ni lati igoke lo.
When you hear the sound of the moving of the wind,
o ni nigba to ba gbo nigba ti atebun
na ba fe, and you see that the trees are being moved,
to ba da bi pe igi na mi,
it will be an indication to you
eleni yo je ami
that the Spirit of the Lord is at move, at work already.
Pe emi Olorun ti bere se na na.
And at that time you will bestir yourself.
Nigba na ni wa ru ara re soke.
You will stir up your faith.
Wa ru igbagbo re soke.
You will rise up urgently.
Wa dide kankan.
You will know it is the time to strike the enemy.
Wa ma pe igba de lati wa kolu ota.
And then the Lord will go out from before you.
Nigba na ni Oluwa yo siwaju re.
And then you will be following after the Lord.
Wa ma tele Oluwa nigba na.
And he is the one that will smite the kingdoms of the heathen.
O fun ara re ni o kolu ogun awon.
And then we are told that David did so as the Lord had commanded him.
Awa so fun wa pe David si se be gege bi Oluwa
ti pase fun. And he smote the Philistines from Geba until thou come unto Gaza.
O si kolu awon Philistine lati Gaba titi won fi de Gaseri.
It is very clear I could multiply the references, but that's not necessary.
Eleyi ti han gbangba bi o ti le je pe awon ese bibeli wa to ye kin fi won ko ye kin se
yala le. But something.
Sugbon mo oye yi.
When it says they subdued kingdoms.
Nigba to so pe won gba ile oba.
What kind of kingdoms did they subdue?
Iru ile oba wo gan ni won gba.
The kingdoms that attempted to hinder them from entering into the promised land.
Awon ile oba ti won gbiyanju lati fe di awon omo Israel lowo lati wo ile.
They were marching on.
Won tesiwaju.
They set their faces as they flinch.
Won ti te oju won
siwaju. They knew the promises of God.
Won mo ile ri Olorun.
They knew the Lord has given us the land.
Won mo pe Oluwa ti fun wa ni ile
na. And there were kingdoms with their kings wanting to hinder them from entering into the promised land.
Awon ile oba kan wa be la won oba kan wa ti a fe di won lowo ki won ko mo de ile
le. They knew that if anybody, if anything raises up its ugly head to hinder us from getting into the land that the Lord has promised us, we can subdue that thing. We shall subdue that thing.
Oye si ye won gbangba wi pe ti ohun ko n ba gbori si soke tabi ohun ko to ba fe dabi igi woroko ti dana ru loju ona wa a o gba ile oba na a o si gba ile
na. There are promises that the Lord has given you.
Opo ileri ni Olorun ti fun
won na. And the kingdom of darkness will want to hinder you from entering into the enjoyment of the promise.
Ijoba okoko yo fe di olowo lati ma gbadun ileri na.
There are things that the Lord has spoken to you directly.
Awon kankan ti be tolorun wa to ti fe soro.
As his own child.
Gege bi omo
re. He has a covenant with you.
O ni ma jemu
pelu re. And he has given you the promise that this is the limit and this is the scope of the promises that I'm giving unto you.
O si ti so fun o gbangba pe wonyi ni odi won awon ileri won ni ti mo fi fun o.
And then any kingdom of darkness wants to hinder you.
Nigba na ijoba okoko fe di olowo.
The kingdom of the flesh wants to hinder you.
Tabi ijoba era ara fe di olowo.
The kingdoms of this world, they want to hinder you.
Tabi ijoba aye yi fe di olowo.
You can subdue those kingdoms.
And
you will subdue those kingdoms.
O si gba awon ile oba
na. You see, for the children of Israel,
ni ti awon omo Israeli,
after they had entered in,
leyin igba ti won wole tan,
there were some other kingdoms that said, all right, we couldn't hinder you, now you have come into the promised land, we are going to prevent you from enjoying the promised inheritance.
Awon ile oba na wa dide si won pe bi o ti le je pe akuna lati din yin lowo lati wo ile na e ti wole na bayi sugbon a o din yin lowo lati gbadun awon ileri re.
Those were powerful enemies indeed.
Awon alagbara ijoba ni
won. Once again, remember, if there is any kingdom that is trying to hinder you and prevent you from enjoying the promises of the Lord, the inheritance of the Lord, you will subdue those kingdoms.
Sugbon lekan si to ranti pe gbangba ni pe bi awon ijoba kan tabi ota kan ti o ba dide si o pe ko mo gbadun awon ileri na wa segun won wa gba ile oba won.
And you see, sometimes that kingdom is even within ourselves.
Igba mi re we awon ijoba won yen ninu aye wa
lo wa. The kingdom of the flesh.
Ijoba ara.
The kingdom of our own attitude.
Ijoba iwa ara
wa. The kingdom of past habits.
Ijoba iwa
atijo. That we need to put under control, that we need to subdue, so that all those things within us will not hinder us from enjoying the promises of the Lord.
Awon nkan to ye ka teri won ba, to ye ka gba ile oba won, ki won to mo ba di wa lowo lati mo gbadun awon ile ileri na.
There is no problem outside you, there is no problem inside you that you cannot conquer.
Ko si wahala kan to wa lode tabi nita re to le bori.
And you will conquer.
Wa si bori.
The word of God says we shall all conquer.
Oro Olorun so pe gbogbo wa la o segun.
In Proverbs chapter 6 16 verse 32.
Owe ori kẹrìndínlógún ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹta
lé lọ́kẹ́ jùlọ. He that is slow to anger is better than the mighty. He that ruleth his own spirit, he is better than he that taketh a city.
Ẹni tí ó lọ́ra àti bínú, ó sàn ju alágbára lọ. Ẹni tí ó ṣe àkóso ẹ̀mí rẹ̀, ó ju ẹni tí ó ṣẹ́gun ìlú lọ.
There you see, for them it was an outside enemy.
Ní ti wọn, ọ̀tá tó wà lóde ni.
But for many of us, it's our own flesh.
Ṣùgbọ́n fún ọ̀pọ̀ nínú wa, ẹran ara wa ló yẹ wá lẹ́nu.
It's our own emotion.
Ìwàsí ìmọ̀lára wa
ni. It's our own way of thinking.
Ọ̀nà tá ń gbà ronú ni.
A lot of things that are coming up inside us, and they make us unfit to claim the promises of the Lord.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ nǹkan tó ń jẹ gùdùgudù nínú ọkàn wa tí ò fààyè gbà wá láti gba àwọn ìlérí Ọlọ́run.
That's why Paul the Apostle said in 1 Corinthians chapter 9.
Ìdí tí Paul àpòsẹ̀ sọ nínú Corinthians kìíní orí kẹsàn-án nìyí.
1 Corinthians chapter 9 verse 27.
Corinthians kìíní orí kẹsàn-án ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹtàdínlọ́gbọ̀n.
He says, but I keep my body under.
Ó ní ṣùgbọ́n èmi pa ara mi lójú.
You see, if you are not careful, there is a kingdom of your flesh, a kingdom of your body that will hinder you from entering into the promised land and enjoying the promised inheritance.
Tí ò bá ronú dáradára, kò ní tètè yọ pé kòkòrò tó ń jẹ̀fọ́ ara ẹ̀fọ́ ló wà. Àwọn ìjọba wọn ni yóò di ẹ lọ́wọ́ láti gba ilẹ̀ ọba.
But I keep under my body.
Èmi pa ara mi lójú.
And I bring it into subjection.
Mo sì mú wá sí abẹ́ ìtẹríba.
Yes, that by enemies, when I preach to others, I myself should be a cast away.
Ṣé lẹ́yìn tí mo ti wàásù fún àwọn ẹlòmíràn nítorí ohunkóhun kí èmi ti kára mi má ṣe di ẹni ìtanù.
Your body will not hinder you.
Ara rẹ ò ní dí ọ lọ́wọ́.
The flesh will not hinder you.
Ẹran ara ò ní dí ọ lọ́wọ́.
Everything the Lord has promised you, you will receive, you will conquer, you will subdue all these kingdoms trying to hinder you from entering in Jesus' name.
Gbogbo ohun tí Ọlọ́run ti ṣèlérí fún ọ pátá ni wàá rí gbà. Àwọn ìjọba tó sì ń dí ọ lọ́wọ́ láti wọ ilẹ̀ ìlérí náà láti gba ilẹ̀.
It said they wrought righteousness.
Ekeji ni pe ni won se ise
ododo. The temptations were great and strong. They wrought righteousness.
Idanwo le pọnra ninu aye won sugbon won se ise ododo.
The community was extremely sinful. They wrought righteousness.
Awujo won buru jai fun ese sugbon won se ise ododo.
The persecution for the righteous was great, yet they wrought righteousness.
Ilo nebi ni fun awon ododo po lopolopo sugbon won se ise ododo.
Many times for some of them there were no people to encourage them and counsel them and lift them up, yet they wrought righteousness.
Àwọn mìíràn tilẹ̀ wà nínú wọn tí ò sí abánikẹ́dùn kò sí agbaninímọ̀ràn ṣùgbọ́n síbẹ̀síbẹ̀ wọ́n ṣiṣẹ́ òdodo.
That means they lived in total obedience to the word of God.
Ìyẹn ni pé wọ́n gbé ìgbé ayé ìgbọràn pátápátá sí Ọlọ́run.
Actually, it is some belief that makes some people to sin and to backslide.
Dájúdájú àìgbàgbọ́ ló máa ń mú kí ènìyàn dẹ́sẹ̀ tàbí kí ó padà sẹ́yìn.
But faith helps us to live a righteous life.
Ṣùgbọ́n ìgbàgbọ́ máa ń ràn wá lọ́wọ́ láti gbé ìgbé ayé òdodo. Ìgbé ayé ìwà bí Ọlọ́run. Ìgbé ayé ìwọ̀ntúnwọ̀nsì.
Present world.
Nínú ayé ìsinsìnyí.
If you have been having difficulty living a righteous life.
Tó bá ní wàhálà láti gbégbé ayé òdodo.
It is not because your community is so dirty. It is because you are weak in faith.
Kìí ṣe pé bóyá àyíká tó wà ló burú lọ́pọ̀lọpọ̀ ṣùgbọ́n ó jẹ́ aláìlera ní ìgbàgbọ́.
Today you will rise up in faith.
Lónìí wàá dìde ní ìgbàgbọ́.
You will move and walk in faith.
Wàá máa rìn wàá máa yan nínú ìgbàgbọ́.
You will march in faith.
Wàá máa yan
bí ọba nínú ìgbàgbọ́. You will resist temptation by faith.
Wàá dojú ìjàkọ ìdánwò
nínú ìgbàgbọ́. And like the Lord helped them by faith to subdue kingdom and to walk out righteousness, the Lord in himself by this divinely imparted faith will help you to be righteous in Jesus' name.
Bí Ọlọ́run ṣe ràn wọ́n lọ́wọ́ tí wọ́n gba ilé ọba nípa ìgbàgbọ́ tí wọ́n ṣiṣẹ́ òdodo nípa ìgbàgbọ́. Nípa ìgbàgbọ́ tí a fi fúnni látòkè wáyé, Olúwa yóò ràn wọ́n náà lọ́wọ́ láti ṣẹ́gun nípa ìgbàgbọ́.
Talking about the people that wrought righteousness by faith.
Tí a bá ń sọ nípa àwọn tó ṣiṣẹ́ òdodo nípa ìgbàgbọ́.
We could easily appoint to Noah.
A lè tọ́ka sí Noah kíákíá.
But thou have I found righteous before me in this generation.
Ó ní ìwọ ni èmi ti rí ní ẹni rere níwájú mi
ní ìrẹ́lẹ̀. We could easily appoint to Joseph.
A lè tọ́ka sí Joseph.
How can I do this sin and sin against my God?
Báwo ni mo ṣe lè ṣe eléyìí kí n wá sẹ̀sìn Ọlọ́run mi?
And we can point to Samuel.
A lè tọ́ka sí Samuel.
Which of you will accuse me of anything? Have I taken bribe? Have I taken anything from you? I will return unto you.
Ó ní ta ni ó lè fẹ̀sùn kàn mí láàrin yín ta ni mo gba kẹ́tẹ́kẹ́tẹ́ rẹ̀ rí tàbí tí mo gba rìbá lọ́wọ́ rẹ̀ rí mo dá padà.
Let us read the reference that is referring to somebody in the old, another one in the new.
Ẹ jẹ́ kí a ka ẹsẹ̀ tó ń tọ́ka sí ẹnìkan nínú májẹ̀mú ńláńlá ẹlòmíràn nínú májẹ̀mú
tuntun. In Job chapter 1.
Nínú Job orí kìíní.
Job chapter 1.
Job orí kìíní.
Reading from verse 8.
A ó kà láti ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹjọ.
And the Lord said unto Satan, hast thou considered my servant Job, that there is none like him in the earth, a perfect and an upright man, one that feareth God and escheweth evil?
Olúwa sì sọ fún Sátani pé ìwọ akíyèsí Job ìránṣẹ́ mi pé kò sí èkejì rẹ̀ lé ayé ọkùnrin tí í ṣe olóòótọ́ ti o si duro sinsin eni ti o beru Olorun ti o si korira iwa buburu.
Can you think of a man, allow me to use this word, that Almighty God in heaven was bragging about him before Satan?
Se iwo na ronu nipa okunrin igba mi laye lati lo gbolohin o en to je pe Olorun Olodumare o wa mo nfonu nipa iru ikokunrin bayi ni waju Satan.
Have you considered my servant Job?
Oni Satani o wa ti kesi wa
iranse mi Job. You are going up and down, you are going to and fro in the world.
Tori po ti so fun mi pe o nlo kaakiri soke sodo nu aye.
You see people that are falling line, right, left and center.
O si si alabapade awon eyan to je pe ye pete ni won subu ni waju re.
You see people that will easily receive any of your suggestion and will fall flat on their faces when you bring temptation to them.
O ti pade iru awon eniyan to je pe nigba to ba fi egbon eyin koro yin re to ba bi tan won je kia kia ni won mo ngba te mo subu.
Have you met one man yet?
So ti wa pade okunrin
kan. Have you tested him yet?
So ti dan obi.
Have you tempted him yet?
So ti yiri awobi.
Have you tried to put all your glittering things that are not pure gold? Have you put all those things before him?
Gbogbo nkan to nda logbon to nda bi wura. So ti mu wa swaju re, so ti subu ri.
Have you tried to shake him?
So ti gbiyanju lati mi.
Have you tried to make him disobey me and obey you?
So ti gbiyanju lati je ko gboran si elenu ko sala igboran si
mi. Have you considered my servant Job?
Ta ti leleni na so ti je irin
ese mi Job. There is none like him on the earth.
Ko se to dabi re ni aye.
A perfect man, an upright man, a righteous man.
Okunrin diduro sinsin olooto eniyan okunrin pipe.
One that feareth God and escheweth evil.
Eni ti o beru Olorun ti o si korira iwa
buburu. You know the devil, he gives some excuse.
Omo esu wa so awon awa
wi kan. Yes, I know that man.
Ah, oni mo mo okunrin yen.
You have blessed him every way.
O ti bukun ni gbogbo ona.
You have made a hedge around him.
O ti so gba yika.
If I touch that man.
Ti n ba fowo kan okunrin yen.
And if I make that man to lose some of the goody goodies of life.
Ti n ba je ko padanu gbogbo to n dan won ni.
And because you've given him quite a lot to support his life.
Tori pe ohun atileyin ninu aye lo ti fi fun.
If I touch his property.
Ti n ba fowo keru re.
You will be surprised. This fellow you are bragging about, he is going to deny you to your face and sin and just follow after me.
Eni ti wo nfonu nipa re yen niwaju mi yo subu yakata yo si doju ti o.
Well, you know what Satan did after that?
Iwo na mo ti Satan se leyin
le. Look at verse 22 of chapter 1 Job.
Iwo wo ese ikejilelogun Job
ori kini. In all these, Job sinned not nor charged God foolishly. Praise the Lord.
Ninu gbogbo eyi Job ko se bẹ́ẹ̀ ni kò sì fi wèrè pé Ọlọ́run lẹ́jọ́
ẹ̀yin olùwàlódò.
Àwọn wàhálà náà wà níbẹ̀ o.
But Job said, I know the way that I've chosen.
Ṣùgbọ́n Job ní èmi mọ̀
ọ̀nà tí mo ti yàn. And I know that my Redeemer liveth.
Mo sì mọ̀ pé olùdáǹdè mi
lẹ. And I know when he has tried me like gold.
Mo mọ̀ pé nígbà tó bá ti dẹ́ mi wò bí wúrà.
I will come out of this thing.
Èmi ó tinú nǹkan yìí jáde.
And he said, with my very eyes will I see him.
Ó ní ojú mi ni èmi ó fi rí.
He said, I will hold on to my integrity.
Èmi yóò sì di ìwà òdodo mi mú.
Even though the problems were there, he wrought righteousness in the Lord.
Yóò tilẹ̀ jẹ́ pé àwọn wàhálà yìí ká síbẹ̀ ó ṣiṣẹ́ òdodo nínú Olúwa.
Eventually the Lord reversed everything and gave him double of what he had before.
Ìwọ náà sì wá mọ̀ pé lópin ohun gbogbo rẹ̀ Ọlọ́run yí gbogbo ìgbà padà fún Ọlọ́run fún ní ìṣẹ́
pọ̀ méjì. In Luke chapter 1,
nínú Luke
orí-kìní, from verse 6,
láti ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹfà.
Luke chapter 1 verse 6,
Luke orí-kìní ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹfà.
This is talking about a servant of the Lord.
Eléyìí tún sọ nípa ìránṣẹ́ Olúwa.
His name is Zechariah.
Orúkọ ẹ̀ ni Zechariah.
And the wife Elizabeth.
Ìyàwó rẹ̀ sì ni Elizabeth.
And now in verse 6 we're told, and they were both righteous before God, walking in all the commandments and the ordinances of the Lord, blameless.
Ní ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹfà ni a ti rí ẹ̀rí nípa àwọn tó ní àwọn méjèèjì ṣiṣẹ́ olódodo níwájú Ọlọ́run, wọ́n rìn ní gbogbo òfin òun ìlànà Olúwa ní àìlẹ́gàn.
Number one, there were people that subdued kingdoms.
Àkọ́kọ́ ni pé àwọn kan gba ilé ọba.
Number two, there were people that wrought righteousness.
Èkejì ni pé àwọn kan ṣiṣẹ́ òdodo.
Number three, there were people that claimed the promises of the Lord.
Ẹ̀kẹta ni pé àwọn kan wà tí wọ́n gba àwọn ìlérí Olúwa.
It says they obtained promises.
Ó ní wọ́n gba ìlérí.
They obtained promises.
Ó ní wọ́n gba ìlérí.
Have you ever tried a study in your own life?
Ṣé o ti gbìyànjú ẹ̀kọ́ yìí nínú ayé rẹ?
You go from Genesis to Revelation.
Kò lọ láti Genesis
dé Ìjọ. And you underline only the promises of the Lord.
Kò wá máa fàlà sí àwọn nǹkan tó jẹ́ ìlérí Ọlọ́run
nínú. You may underline it with a particular color of a biro.
O wá lè mú ẹ̀yà biro kan kó máa fi sàmì sí.
And just begin to look at the promises of God, just underline them, underline them.
Kò wá máa wo àwọn ìlérí Ọlọ́run, kò wá máa fàlà sí wọn, kò máa fàlà sí wọn.
And then it will help you once in a while over the weekend, you just open your Bible, and since it's a particular color, maybe red or green or yellow or whatever, you just look at that color all through your Bible, just sinking in, just soaking in, just assimilating the promises of God in your life.
Anytime
you are discouraged, you pick up that Bible and look for that color every page and just be reading the promises of God, reading the promises of God. Anytime you become afraid, just read the promises of the Lord. Anytime there is a challenge to your life, anytime the devil is saying there is no way here, I am going to see where you are going to pass, you take your Bible, you look at those promises, and you look at the coloring. Before 5 minutes, before 10 minutes, light will come your way.
Nigba ti esu ba ra gabu doju ona to ni ona ti pe ko su oju ona fun lati rin ni mo nigba na ko wa nawo gan bibeli re ko wa wo awo to fi se awon ileri olorun ko wa ma wo imale
yo wa sa re to the presence of God.
Ko wa lo si waju oluwa,
you open that Bible,
ko wa si bibeli
yen, you open the promise of God,
ko si awon ileri olorun.
Even when you cannot pray,
nigba to ti ele gbadura,
when it appears the enemy is trying to make you afraid,
to dabi eni pe ota mu ogbe,
you open a particular promise,
so what see
you read
kan,
it out loud,
to kas, okay.
You say, God, that's what you said, arise and scatter your enemies and do it for me. Then you open another page of scripture, and then you read another promise in the hearing of God. You say, heaven and earth may pass away, but the promise of God, the word of God, can never pass away. Then you hold on to that promise again, and after you have gone through about 5 or 6 or 7 promises of God, you close that Bible, then you say, Lord, if you can fail, it's only then those promises will not be fulfilled. If the sun can refuse to shine, if the day will not appear after night, it's only then those promises will not be fulfilled. As long as you are the God in heaven that lives, and you are the God in heaven that gives me this promise, I know that I am victorious and nothing will defeat my life. And then you begin to see,
then
you come out of your closet, the enemy will see the glory of the Lord upon your face. And so you see these people, they obtain the promises of the Lord, and that is what we are to do today, because actually the Lord has given us great and precious promises. Second Peter chapter 1, reading from verse 4, whereby are given unto us exceeding great and precious promises, that by these ye might be partakers of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption that is in the world through
laws. Ti o tobi pupo ti o si se yebiye fun wa pe nipa ewon yi ni ki eyin ki o le di alaba pin ninu iwa Olorun nigba ti eyin ba ti yo kuro ninu ibaje tin be ninu aye nipa ife kuke.
Like Abraham, you will not consider your own body that is almost dead.
Gaga bi Abraham, o ni ma wa ara
re, you will not consider the body of Sarah,
o ni ma wa ara Sarah.
You will be looking at the Lord every time, not looking at yourself.
Gbogbo igba Oluwa ni wa ma wo ni wa ara.
You will not look at your mountain,
o ni ma wo oke re,
because that mountain will definitely move.
Tori pe oke yen o
let's go to point number 2, the possibilities of supernatural faith. It's not possible to look at all the references, the possibilities of supernatural faith. When we talk about possibilities, what can faith do in the heart, in the life of a man, of a woman, that will be looking unto God and will not look at any problem? In Mark chapter 9, reading from verse 23, here are the words of the Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus said unto him, if thou canst believe, all things are possible to him that believeth. You know, if you can just change position tonight, and you quit the seat of unbelief and you sit on the seat seat of faith.
To dide fu ku lori aga igbagbo ti o wa lo joko lori aga igbagbo.
And you reach the camp of unbelief and you come into the camp of the faithful.
To kuro ni egbe awon alaigbagbo to wa wa si egbe awon onigbagbo.
And you stop the negative confession and the negative pronouncement from your mouth and you begin to confess, you begin to pronounce only the promises of God.
To wa dawo duro lati ma soro to lodi jade lenu re to je pe latoni lo oro igbagbo oro to ye koro ni ma tenu re jade.
And then you believe the Lord that with God all things are possible. If thou canst believe tonight, I said if thou canst believe tonight, because you know there are some people in deeper life, they are waiting for Thursday, and when Monday comes, and we're talking about faith, we're talking about exploits, we're talking about supernatural acts, they say, but today is Monday. Yes, today is Monday, but God is alive.
Àwọn kan ti wà nínú ìjọ dípàlà tó ti di ibárakú fún wọn pé ọjọ́ àlàmísì ni wọ́n máa ń fẹ́ ká sọ nípa ìgbàgbọ́. Tá a bá ń sọ nípa ìgbàgbọ́ ní ọjọ́ ajé wọn ni ọjọ́ ajé lónìí. Kí ló dé tí ń sọ nípa ìgbàgbọ́? Òótọ́ ni ọjọ́ ajé lónìí ṣùgbọ́n Ọlọ́run wà
láàyè.
Sọlọ́run lè múni ládá lọ́jọ́ ajé.
Can God deliver on Monday?
I said,
can God provide on Monday? Can God turn away the enemy from you on Monday? Can the Lord break the head of the devil, crush the head of the devil by your faith on Monday? Yes, we know Thursday is there and Thursday is coming. But before that Thursday, you are going to get your own today. If you can only believe, Jesus Christ said, all things are possible. All things are possible. Don't be discouraged. All things are possible. Don't run back. All things are possible to him that
believeth.
In Matthew chapter 17 verse 20. Here Jesus said unto them, because of your unbelief, but verily I say unto you, if ye have faith as a grain of mustard seed, ye shall say unto this mountain. Are you ready to say unto that mountain? Ye shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed, and then it says to yonder place, remove hence to yonder place, and it shall remove. Jesus said, it shall remove. Can Jesus lie? Didn't he mean what he said? Didn't he say exactly what he meant? It says, it shall remove, and nothing shall be impossible unto you.
Ni ese ogun Jesu wi fun won pe nitori igbagbo yin ni looto ni mo sa wi fun yin bi eyin ba ni igbagbo bi woro erogbe mustard eyin yo wi fun oke yi pe lale igan le so be o e wi fun oke yi pe sidi yin lo si ohun yo sisi Jesu so wi pe yo sisi se Jesu le paro ni se Jesu a ma se keni o ni ko si si nkan ti e ki yo le se.
In Philippians chapter 4 verse 13.
Ninu Philippi ori keni ese iketala.
He said, I can do all things.
O ni emi le se ohun
gbogbo. Isn't it wonderful for a believer?
Se le o wa je yanu ko ni
gbagbo. To say what Elijah has done.
Pe ohun ti Elijah
ti se. What Elisha has done.
Ohun ti Elisha ti se.
What David has done.
Ohun ti David
ti se. What Joshua has done.
Ohun ti Joshua ti se.
What all those warriors of old, heroes of faith in the Old Testament, what they have achieved.
Ohun ti awon eni nla igbani awon akikanju igbagbo ohun ti won ti se nipa igbagbo.
I in my situation, in my circumstances today,
emi ninu ipo ati ayida igbagbo
mo wa loni, at the time of need today,
ni akoko eni loni,
I can do all things through Christ which strengthens me.
Emi le se ohun gbogbo ninu Kristi eni ti n fi agbara fun mi.
Now what were the possibilities spoken about in this passage you are looking at?
Kini awon nkan to se ti a so nipa re nipa igbagbo
yi? There are three things again in this group of study.
Ohun meta lo tun wa ninu ipa meta ti
ikoko yi. We are looking at the end of verse 33 and the beginning of verse 34. It says, they stopped the mouths of lions. They stopped the mouths of lions. And then in verse 34, they quenched the violence of fire. And then number 3 now in this group, they escaped the edge of the sword. I don't think I need to read Daniel chapter 6 with you. You know the story so well, how Daniel was thrown into the lion's there.
He stopped
the mouth of lions by faith. But then you say, but we are not being thrown into the lions today. Yes, there are some ferocious men. Aggressive men. When I say ferocious, that means the people that are fiery, the people that are aggressive, the people that are violent, the people that are cruel, the people that are mischievous, and they want to bounce on your life and destroy your life.
I
want
to be olubi eniyan. Àwọn ọ̀tọ̀ àrùn ògbẹ́bọ, àwọn tó jẹ́ pé wọn ìfẹ́rẹ́ fẹ́ èèyàn, àwọn tó jẹ́ pé ibi ènìyàn ni ó máa ń wá lójoojúmọ́ ni à ń sọ nípa wọn.
They are lions in this world.
Kìnì ni wọ́n nínú ayé yìí.
But you will overcome them.
Ṣùgbọ́n wàá borí wọn.
You will stop their mouth.
Wàá pa wọ́n lẹ́nu mọ́.
You open their mouth like this.
Tí ẹ bá lanu wọn báyìí.
Only fly will get in, you will not get into their mouth.
Èsì ni ó wọ̀ wọ́n lẹ́nu, ìwọ kọ́ ló wọ̀ wọ́n lẹ́nu.
In Psalm 57.
Nínú orin Dáfídì kẹtàdínlọ́gọ́ta. Orin kẹtàdínlọ́gọ́ta.
I want you to look at it from verse 4. My soul is among lions. I lie among them that are set on fire. And then even the ways of men whose teeth are spears and arrows.
Ati àwọn tí eyín wọn àti ọkàn wọn dàbí ọkọ àti ọfà àti ahọ́n wọn ìdàmímú.
You see, there are times we are surrounded by enemies that want to crush us. They want to behave like lions against our life.
Ìgbà míì wà tí àwọn tó yí wa ká wọn mọ hùwà gẹ́gẹ́ bí ìkìnnìún láti fẹ́ pa yìí wa run.
But David overcame.
Ṣùgbọ́n Dáfídì borí wọn.
And we shall overcome.
Àwa náà yóò borí.
In verse 5, be thou exalted, O God, above the heavens, and it says over here, let thy glory be above all the earth.
Ní ẹsẹ̀ ìkarùn ló ti wá sọ pé gbígbéga ni ọ Ọlọ́run ju ọ̀run lọ àti ògo rẹ ju gbogbo ayé lọ.
They have prepared a net for my steps.
Ó ní wọ́n ti ta àwọ̀ sílẹ̀
fún ẹsẹ̀ mi.
Wọ́n tẹ orí ọkàn mi bá.
They have dig a pit before me.
Wọ́n ti wa ihò sílẹ̀ níwájú
mi. In the midst whereof they are falling themselves.
Ní àárín èyí náà ni àwọn ti kara wọ́n jìn sí.
My heart speaks to God, my heart speaks, I will sing and I will give praise.
Ọkàn mi ti múra Ọlọ́run, ọkàn mi ti múra, èmi ó kọrin, èmi ó sì máa kọrin.
There were times Paul the apostle tells us it was like he was faced with lion-like men wanting to destroy his life.
Ìgbà kan wà tí Paul apòsẹ́lì sọ fún wa wípé òun dojú kọ àwọn ènìyàn tó jẹ́ pé ẹ̀yà ayé wọn bíi ti kìnìún ni
gbẹ́gbẹ́ báyìí rẹ̀. In 2 Timothy chapter 4.
Nínú Timothy kejì orí kẹrin.
And in verse 17.
Ní ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹtàdínlógún.
2 Timothy chapter 4 verse 17.
Timothy kejì orí kẹrin ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹtàdínlógún.
Notwithstanding, the Lord stood with me and strengthened me.
Ó ní ṣùgbọ́n Olúwa gba ẹjọ́ mi rò, ó sì fún mi lágbára.
That by me the preaching might be fully known, and that all the Gentiles might hear.
Ó ní àti pé kí ó ní pé nípasẹ̀ mi kí a lè wàásù náà ní àwàjálẹ̀, àti pé kí gbogbo àwọn kèfìrí kí ó lè gbọ́.
And I was delivered from what? From the mouth of the lion.
A sì gbà mí kúrò ní ẹnu kíni o.
Whatever lions are around in your community, persecutors that are so fierce and aggressive and violent like lions, the Lord will deliver you. Even from the devil, a roaring lion that walketh about seeking whom he may devour, the Lord will deliver you. All these passages are reassuring us there is no limit to what faith can do in our lives.
Gbogbo àwọn ẹsẹ̀ ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run ló fi wá lọ́kàn balẹ̀ pé kò sí tí ìgbàgbọ́ ò lè gbéṣe nínú ayé wa.
Number 2 in this group of expressions is telling us of those that quench the violence of fire.
Ní eléèkejì nínú ẹgbẹ́ tí à ń kà yìí ni àwọn tí ó pa agbára iná.
You know the story yourself.
Ìwọ náà mọ ìtàn yìí fúnra rẹ.
Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
Shadrach, Meshach, àti Abednego.
They were thrown into the fiery furnace.
A jù wọ́n sínú ìléru náà.
Because they refused to bow down, they refused to worship the image of the king.
Torí pé wọ́n kọ̀ láti tẹríba kí wọn kí ó sì ṣe èrè ọba.
And then he threw them into the fire.
Ó wá jù wọ́n sínú ìléru iná.
Were they burnt?
Ṣé wọ́n jóná bí?
Were they hurt?
Ṣé apá wọn lára bí?
Were they killed?
Ṣé apá wọn bí?
Were they destroyed?
Ṣé apá wọn run bí?
No, not at all.
Rárá, kò sẹlẹ̀.
You may be going through trials, fiery trials.
Ó lè máa la wàhálà tó dàbí iná kọjá.
The Lord is going to preserve your life.
Olúwa yóò pa ẹ̀mí rẹ mọ́.
That thing will not kill you.
Ohun yìí ò ní pa
ọ́. Some people say fire is burning in my family.
Àwọn kan sọ pé iná ń jó nínú ẹbí mi.
The Lord will bring that fire down.
Olúwa yóò pa iná náà.
He will quench the violence of fire in your family. Don't give up. Just rely on the promises of God. When you pass through the fire, it will not burn you. And through the water, it will not drown you. In 1 Peter chapter 1, and in verse 5, who are kept by the power of God through faith unto salvation, ready to be revealed at the last time. The Lord will keep you. Wherein ye greatly rejoice, though now for a season, if need be, ye are in heaviness through manifold temptations. That the trial of your faith, being much more precious than of gold that perisheth, though it be tried with fire, might be found unto praise and honor and glory in the appearing of Jesus Christ.
Ati ninu ogo ni farahan Jesu Christi.
And the Lord is going to preserve our lives. Oluwa
yo pa aye wa mo.
I told you before, I'm going to tell you again.
Mo ti so fun yin tele, mo tun so fun yin
si. Until your assignment God wants you to accomplish on earth has been totally accomplished without any jot or tittle remaining, until everything has been done, nothing can take you away from this place.
Ohun ti mo so fun ani wi pe titi ti ojuse ti Olorun ti yan fun aye re ti yo fi pari lai seku kankan ninu re ko si nkan kan to le mu won kuro loke ye pe yi.
And then it says they escaped the edge of the sword.
O to so pe won bo ni oju ida.
How are we going to be talking about that?
Ba la se fe ma so nipa
eleyi. You know many times that David wanted was to be killed by Saul.
O ma ku opo igba ni Saul fe pa David.
He escaped the edge of the sword.
O bo lowo oju ida.
Don't you know many times how the Lord preserved some people? Do you remember Elijah? Jezebel said, if the Lord, the gods, they will do so to me and more. If I don't make you like one of those prophets by this time tomorrow, I will cut off your head. He escaped the edge of the sword, and the Lord raptured him to heaven without seeing
them.
You remember Elisha? There was a famine in the land. And one woman went to the king. And she said, deliver me, O king. And the king said, why will I deliver you? And then he said, what aileth thee? And then that woman said, we had an arrangement because of the famine, because of the drought. And we said, we will eat my child today, and tomorrow we will eat the other fellow's child. We ate my own yesterday, and this fellow, it comes to our turn now, is hiding his child and will not allow us to eat.
Obirin wa pata to sele fun oba wipe ohun to sele ni pe emi atobirin yi a fi mo so kan wipe omo awa mejeji a o je kan loni a o je kan lola temi lati wa kokko je o wa sukan omo ti re bayi o wa fa keko ri pa ni jomo ti re.
And then the king removed this clothes.
Oba wa pa so
ya very very sad.
O ni ibanuje
le po lo. There is only one person I'm going to deal with.
O ni enikan ni mo fi mu
epo pe. A prophet in this land, and he cannot change the situation.
And Elijah
was sitting with the elders.
And
while the king was coming, wanted to take off his head, he said, look at the son of this murderous woman coming to kill me, coming to take my head. And then the spirit of prophecy came upon him. He said, what am I waiting for again? Then he made the announcement. He said, the famine is over. By this time tomorrow, the food, the meal will be served, and the meal will be bought with little amounts of money.
And
then the fellow on whose hand the king was leaning said, even if the Lord will open the windows of heaven, might these things be? And Elisha said, you are a doubter in this one we are talking about. You will see what your eyes will not partake of it.
That's the way
he escaped the edge of the sword. Whatever the enemies are planning, whatever they are doing behind the tree, whatever they are doing by the riverside, they say they are planning against your life. I said no, never. I say no, never. Because you will escape the danger coming upon your life in Jesus' name. I told you at the beginning that this thing is so loaded and this thing is so much that it's very difficult to read all the references. It has come to point number 3. The power of steady, stable faith. If you will believe in the Lord with faith that is stable, faith that is steady, faith that will not shake, faith that will hold on to the Lord, here you will find the manifestation of power. You'll find the exploits that steady faith can accomplish in your life. Look at it in the latter part of verse 34. It says, out of weakness they were made strong. They were weak, like you and like me. They thought they will not be able to do it. They thought they will not be able to achieve. They thought this assignment the Lord has given me is beyond my strength. I've never faced anything like this before. I sense my weakness. I see my weakness. And I see I can do nothing. But out of weakness they were made strong. And that's what you find among the people of God. Do you remember Gideon? Oh yes, he felt he was weak. And then the Lord gave him only 300 men. In fact, he was even a little bit fearful. Until the Lord sent him to the Midianites and he said, go and see the dream they are already relating. And when he had all those things, he became strong in the Lord. Do you remember also that king in Second Chronicles chapter 20? Our time is gone, but I cannot do without reading this one. Are you in a hurry? Second Chronicles chapter 20. Second Chronicles chapter 20. You see, all these armies and all these kingdoms, they came against him. Against Jehoshaphat. And he felt weak. Verse 12. Our God, wilt thou not judge them? For we have no might against this great company that cometh against us.
Neither
know we what to do, but our eyes are upon thee. Yes, they were weak. They fell small. They could not overcome. It is not your feeling, it is your faith. And then it says, out of weakness they were made strong by their faith in God. Do you remember it was this Jehoshaphat in verse 20 that told these people? He said, believe the Lord your God and so shall ye be established, believe his prophets and so shall ye prosper. After that, he came out of that weakness, he became strong. And when he had consulted with the people, he appointed singers unto the Lord that they should praise the beauty of holiness as they went out before the army, and to say, praise the Lord, for his mercy endureth forever. And when they began to sing and to praise, when you are in the midst of battle, when they began to sing and to praise, when you feel that your enemy is stronger than you are, but when you begin to sing and to praise, when you sense in yourself weakness and you feel we have no strength against the enemy, and yet you begin to sing and to praise,
when you feel
kere ko si agbara ti wa bi koju ota to wa bere si kore to yin oluwa.
You don't run away from the enemy because you feel you are weak.
O ni sani waju ota nitori pe ori
pe o lagbara. You don't abandon your assignment because you feel you are weak.
O ni foju se re sile nitori pe o ni malara pe o lagbara.
You don't give up your right. You don't give up what belongs to you to another fellow and say, well, I cannot do it. There's nothing I can do. I'm so weak in myself. Just because you are weak, rise up and sing and praise the Lord, and your strength will come.
O ni ju eto re nu fun awon elomiran nitori pe o ni mo lara pe ko si agbara tabi ko se pa ninu alagbara re dide ni igba to ba bere si korin agbara yo wole.
When they began to sing and to praise,
nigba ti won bere si korin ati si yin oluwa,
the Lord set ambushment against the children of Ammon and the children of Moab and the Mount Seir, which were against Judah, and they were smitten.
Oluwa yan ogun eyin si awon omo Ammoni, Moabu ati awon ara oke Seiri ti o wa si Judah as a kolu won.
Out of weakness they were made strong.
Aso won di alagbara ninu ailera.
Look for people like Paul the apostle.
Ope ni fun Olorun fun awon eyan bi Paul apostle.
I will glory in my infirmities.
O le mi o ma sogo ninu ailera mi.
When I am weak, then I am strong.
O ni nitori igba ti mo wa ni ailera nigba na ni mo je alagbara.
You are not weak again.
O je alagbara.
Your body may be weak.
Ara re le dabi eni ti o lagbara.
You may not be a university graduate with high kind of knowledge.
O le ma lo sile eko university pelu oye nla lopolo re.
Faith will make you strong.
Sugbon igbagbo yo
se lagbara. Stronger than your enemy.
Wa lagbara jo
ta re. Stronger than the people that are looking for your life.
Wa lagbara jo awon to ndo de mi re.
And then it tells us in chapter 11 of Hebrews verse 34.
O tun so fun abakan na ni ori kokan la ebere ese ikeni ni logo.
Valiant in fight.
Oni won di akoni ni ija.
What valiant in fight.
Won di akoni ni ija.
It's not that they were never tired.
Ki se pe ko re won rara.
That's not the reason. It says they were valiant in fight.
Iyan kon ni di to so pe won di akoni ni ija.
You know, some people say, I don't know, I'm always tired. I feel weak whenever I rise up to fight against the enemy.
Awon kan won ma nko won ma sa won awoyi pe mu o ma to kolu mi igba ki igba tin ba fe dide lati koju si ota agbara mi o nto nkan.
They too, they were weak.
Awon na won di alai lagbara.
They felt they could not do it.
O ro pa won o le se rara.
But when faith entered into them and they operated by faith, it said they were valiant in fight.
Sugbon nigba ti igbagbo wonu aye won ti won wa gbegbese igbagbo bibeli so pe won di akoni ni ija.
You will read all the references yourself.
Won na fun ara re wa ta
re se yen. Joshua.
So lati Joshua.
Just a few chapters before chapter 10.
Ori die ka to di ori kewa.
The people of Ai, they had even killed some of the children of Israel.
Awon ara ilu Ai won ti lu
pade lu omo Israel. Joshua went on his face before the Lord.
Joshua si to Oluwa lo do
lu bere. What am I going to say?
O ni Oluwa kini ke
ti o ma so. When the children of Israel turn back from their enemies.
Nigba ti awon Israel san
niwaju ota won. All the other people will hear about it.
Gbogbo eniyan ni yo gbo nipa
re. And they will be after all.
Won yo si ma le pa
wa. And then the Lord encouraged him.
Oluwa wa mo lokan le.
The Lord will encourage you.
Oluwa yo mu ona lokan
le. And then by the time you get to chapter 10.
Nigba ta wa dori kewa.
And there's no time to read the reference, you read it yourself when you get home.
Ko saye lati ka awon ese bibeli to ba dele
ko pa. And the battle was very very fierce.
Ogun na wa gbona jaja.
And the night was coming on.
Ale wa nbo.
See this man Joshua.
Wa wo ko re
Joshua. He just stood where he was.
O kan duro nibi to wa.
He looked at the sun where the sun was.
O wo oro nibi to wa yen.
He said, "Sun, stand still there until I finish finishing the enemy."
O ni iwo oro duro nibi to wa yen tin won fi bori awon oda.
And you moon, stay right there until I finish to finish finishing the enemy.
O ni iwo osupa ni tire na duro sibi to wa yen tin won fi pin
ajo awon oda. And the Bible records there, it says there was no other day when God answered the voice of a man like that and the sun stood still.
Bibeli sise akosile re wipe ko ti si ojo kan tabi ojo miran bi re ti Olorun dahun adure eniyan ti orun duro be.
You see, it is because of their faith in God.
Ohun to so ko fa re ni igbagbo won ninu Olorun.
That's how they were valiant in fight.
Bi won se di akoni loju ija ni.
There is this reference of the Bible that I want you to mark in your Bible. That's why I want to read it now.
Ese bibeli kan wa ti mo fe ko falasi ninu bibeli re idi ti mo fi fe kan niyi.
It's in 2 Samuel chapter 23.
Samuel keje ori ketalelogun ni.
And in verse 10.
Ni ese ikewa.
It says he arose and he smote the Philistines until his hand was weary.
O si dide, o si kolu awon Philistine titi owo fi ko.
And his hand clave unto the sword.
Owo re si le maida.
And the Lord wrought a great victory.
Oluwa si se ese igbala ni ojo na.
Now you will see that although this man was weary, although this man was tired, his hand was holding on to the sword until he became valiant in the Lord and he turned to fly the armies of the aliens.
Ori okunrin yi ikare mo titi to de pe owo re le maida sugbon o tesiwaju titi And
then in Hebrews chapter 11 verse 34,
and
they turned to flight the armies of the
aliens.
Strangers that wanted to drive them away from the promised land, they drove them
away.
Somebody wants to drive you from your husband's house. Somebody wants to take your wife away from you. Somebody wants to get into your property and take it away from you. What are you going to do?
What
are you going to say? The country is very bad. That is how the people of the world are doing today. They will not allow you to enjoy your husband. All these people that are just coming, and you see the world is so bad. If you report them to policemen, police will not rise up.
There is
injustice in the cause. What am I going to do now? Oh Lord, allow me to endure. That they will take away my husband. They will not take away my salvation. That's how you are going to approach the matter. You cannot have faith that cannot be conquered. Faith that will drive the enemy away. And you will what valiant in the fight. We need to fight the good fight of faith. And all the kingdoms shall be subdued. And anything that all that the Lord has promised you has given unto you, there's somebody from somewhere that will be coming around your doorstep to take that thing away from you. The faith in us tonight will drive them away in Jesus' name.
We are
going to overcome.
Whether
it's the flesh, we will overcome. Or the devil will overcome.
Or
it is the world we will overcome. The Lord has given us the victory already. And this is the victory that overcomes the world, even our faith. If you are not in a hurry, we are going to pray tonight. Because there must be spectacular acts of faith in your own life. There should be achievements of faith in your own life. There must be exploits of faith in your own life. We have read about these people. Somebody must read about your life one day. Must read about your faith one day. And tonight you will not accept no for an answer. Because if you can believe in the Lord tonight, all things are possible for them that believe. If you can believe the Lord tonight, you can say unto this mountain, be thou removed, and it shall be so. If you will believe the Lord tonight, you will subdue kingdom. You will walk righteousness. You will obtain the promises. You will stop the mouth of lions. You will quench the violence of fire. You will escape the edge of the sword. Your weakness will be made strong. You will
walk
valiant in battle, valiant in fight. You will turn to fly the armies of the aliens. I can do all things. I can do all things. I can do all things. Through Christ that strengthens me. He will strengthen you. He will energize you. He will uplift you. He will uphold you. You will turn to fly the armies of the aliens. You can be victorious. You are an overcomer already. It is faith in us that makes us to overcome. In all the temptations of life, in all the conditions, situations, vicissitudes of life, you can overcome. It's just by faith. It's just by faith. Believe in the Lord. You will subdue the kingdoms. Believe in the Lord. You will turn to fly the armies of the aliens. Believe in the Lord. You will be righteous. You will be holy. You will overcome temptation. You will walk out righteousness. Believe the Lord. You will obtain the promises. You will inherit the promises. Believe the Lord. You will stop the mouth of the lions. All those ferocious men, all those violent men, all those aggressive men, all the people that are trying to intimidate you in your life, you will stop the mouths of lions. Out of your weakness you are going to be made strong. Out of your weakness you are going to be made strong. Don't accept that you are weak. Don't accept that you are weak. Don't accept that you cannot overcome. Don't accept that the enemy is stronger than you are. Don't accept that they will take your right away from you. Don't accept they will make you fall. Don't accept they will take your children. Don't accept they will take your wife. Don't accept they will take your husband. Don't accept they will take your inheritance. Don't accept that you are weak. In weakness you are made strong by faith. Don't accept that you cannot overcome temptation. Don't accept that you will backslide. Don't accept that you will be falling and falling and falling and falling. Believe that you are strong. Believe that you are strong. Believe that you will overcome. Believe that you are more than a conqueror. Believe that they will not overcome you. Believe that you will stand by faith. You will wax valiant in fight. You will wax valiant in fight. You will turn to fly the armies of the aliens. Your right belongs to you. Your right belongs to you. The promises of God belong to you. The goodness of the Lord belongs to you. The grace of God belongs to you. Exceeding great and precious promises. Don't you know that your God is able? He's able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we ask or think because of the power that worketh in us. Who can make you afraid? Who can turn you away from the battlefield? Who can defeat you? Who can bring down fall in your life? Who can take what belongs to you? Who can cancel the goodness of the Lord in your life? Who can cancel the promises of God in your life? Why don't you accept the promises of God at face value? Accept the promises of God at face value. Say to this mountain. Say to this mountain. Say to this mountain. Be thou removed. Be thou removed. Be thou removed. Be cast into the sea. Jesus said it shall be so. Jesus said it shall be so. Jesus said it shall be so. And nothing shall be impossible unto you. Only believe. And you will see the glory of God. You will see the glory of the Lord. Subdue those kingdoms. Walk righteously. Obtain the promises. Don't allow any lion to terrify your life. The wicked people in the office, don't allow them to intimidate you. As the people in the yard where you are living, don't allow anybody to make you afraid. The people that are carrying stories about and are coming to tell you, do you know what they are planning against you? Do you know what they are planning against you? Don't allow them to bring fear into your heart. Stop the mouth of the lion. Quench that violence of the fire. And you will escape the hedge of the soul. Don't be weak. Don't be weak. Out of your weakness become strong. Be valiant in the battle. And you turn to flight the armies of the aliens. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray.
orukọ Jesu ni agbadura.
My brothers and sisters, you have seen what faith has done.
Arakunrin ati arabinrin mi, e ti rin ti igbagbo
ti se. You have seen what faith can do.
O ti rin ti igbagbo le se.
It is your own turn today.
O wa kan loni.
We have read about the exploits of faith in the lives of other people.
Ati ka nipa ise agbara igbagbo ninu aye
awon kan. About the spectacular acts of faith in the lives of other people.
Nipa ise agbara nipa igbagbo ninu aye awon kan.
We have heard about the people that became strong in their weakness.
O ti ri awon to da lagbara ninu
aye awon. About the people that silenced the lions.
Awon to pa kinu
ile lo mo. About the people that obtained the promises.
Awon to gba awon ileri.
We have read about the people that subdued kingdoms.
Ati ka nipa awon to gba ile
ijoba. We have read about the people that quenched the violence of fire.
Ati ka nipa awon to pa agbara
ina. We have read about the people that turned the enemies away.
Agbo nipa awon to ti sle awon
odalo. We have read about the people that will not accept the enemy to come into their territory. They made them to run away.
Ati ka nipa awon ti o faye gbota lati wa sadu gbo
wa le odalo. Why are we studying about them?
Kino de ta se nka ta
nka so nipa won. It is so that you will not stand in faith.
Ki won ba le duro ninu igbagbo ni.
And that problem in your life will be solved.
Ki wahala to wa nu aye re le
yoju. That Jericho one in your life will fall.
Odi Jericho nu aye re ko le
wo. That sickness in your life will be removed.
Aisan ninu aye re ko le
lo. That oppression will be taken away.
Idaloro yen ko le
kuro. That weakness will vanish away.
Ikaara yen ko le dope.
That lack of courage will be turned around.
Ainigboya yen ko le yi pada.
And you have not been sleeping in the night.
O kin sun loru.
You have been thinking about what the enemies were saying.
O ronu nipa
nkan tan so. You have been very weak.
O ti di en ti o lagbara mo rara.
But today you want to come before the Lord.
Ṣùgbọ́n lónìí o fẹ́ wá síwájú
Olúwa. You want to rise up in the arms of faith.
O fẹ́ dìde ní ipa
ìgbàgbọ́. You want to lean upon the everlasting
arm. O fẹ́ sinmi ní apá ayé.
In your weakness you want to become strong.
Nínú àìlera o fẹ́ dá lágbára.
In your sickness you want to become well.
Nínú àìsàn o fẹ́ dá lágbára.
In your humility you want to climb upon the rock, upon the mountain.
Nípò ìrẹ̀lẹ̀ rẹ o fẹ́ dìde kó lọ sórí òkè
náà. And all the things that have been trying to terrify you.
Gbogbo tó fi ń dúnkokò mọ́
abẹ́lẹ̀. And they have been trying to hinder you from enjoying the promises of the
Lord.
You want to claim the victory tonight. You want to claim the victory tonight. You want to claim the victory tonight. This is your own time. To subdue all the kingdoms of darkness all around you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
I believe tonight you will experience the power of the Lord. Everybody, you just raise up your hand. The time of victory has come. The time to subdue the kingdom has come. The time to quench that fire in your family, that time has come. The time to turn the flight, all the enemies, to make them to fly, to flee away, that time has come. The time for the weak to become strong, that time has come. The time to say, Lord, I am here. All that you have done for people in Bible days, you will do in my life. That time has come. Just keep up your hand for a few minutes. As we pray together, believe the Lord. Just believe the Lord. You are victorious. You will overcome. They will not drive you away from your heritage. Almighty God, we come to you tonight. We thank you because of what you have shown us from your word. Thank you because of these men and women. In their own days, in their own time, they were made strong. In their own time, they turned to fly the armies of the aliens. In their own time, they were valiant in the battle on the battlefield. In their own time, they subdued kingdoms. Actually, everything was possible with them. This is our own time. I bring all our brothers and sisters before you. Oh Lord, I'm asking right now. Everyone that has felt very weak, I pray that the might and the strength of the Lord will enter into their lives in Jesus' name.
You
have given us exceeding and great promises. Precious promises. And there are kingdoms of darkness, kingdoms of the world, kingdoms energized by the flesh, trying to hinder them entering into the promised land, entering into the inheritance, enjoying the goodness of the Lord.
Oh
Lord, I pray right now, before every brother, before every sister, all of those kingdoms, they are subdued in Jesus' name. All the powers of the enemy, all the powers of the kingdoms of darkness, because every yoke that may be upon any life here, oh Lord, I break them in Jesus' name. I pray for people who want to serve you, they want to follow you, they want to obey you, they want to live righteous life, but there's a particular habit in their life. And when they're making consecration, when they're saying, now I'm going to rise up and walk righteously, all of
them suddenly,
that temptation will come again and will make them to fall into sin. They're
preached,
they have done a lot of things, they try to deny themselves, but they have been falling and falling and falling. Oh Lord, I pray today, that prayer that makes us to walk righteously, I pray, oh Lord, give it to them in Jesus' name. That habit of always falling into sin, I pray that you break, you destroy that habit in Jesus' name. The boldness to live a righteous life, the power to live an upright life, the obedience that will make them to walk out righteously, I pray you give unto them in Jesus' name. The people that have been holding on to the promises of God, they have read those promises, they have repeated those promises, they have believed those promises, they have claimed those promises, and that appears is here to be fulfilled in their life. And you have been encouraging them that you have God that will change now, and yet it appears they are not seeing the fulfillment of the promise. Oh Lord, I am praying today that this promise will be fulfilled in their lives in Jesus' name. Oh Lord, I pray for them, your own children, every promise you have given them, every promise in your world, I pray, oh Lord, in their own family, the promise of childbearing, the promise of healing, the promise of deliverance, the promise of provision, the promise of protection, the promise of holiness, every kind of promise, the promise of your power in the life of a sanctified vessel. Oh Lord, those who have been missing your promises, I pray that from this very night, you fulfill the promises in them in Jesus' name.
There
are people that it appears as some lion-like men pursuing them, ferocious men pursuing them, violent men pursuing them. Oh Lord, I pray your children will not be defeated. I pray they will silence those lions in Jesus' name. They want to devour them, they want to crush them, they want to swallow them up, and I pray you will give your children victory in Jesus' name.
The
people, oh Lord, you know the fire is burning in their family, husband making trouble, wife making trouble, children becoming wayward in their places of what they will not allow them to rest. It appears it's almost like they should even run away from where they are. Sometimes the fire is not only burning externally, it's burning within their body.
When
they wear clothes, but it appears they are putting on fire. Oh Lord, you are the one that can quench the violence of fire. And I pray that in their brain, I pray that in their body, I pray that in all their system, anywhere the fire of the devil is burning, I pray you will put it up, you will quench it in Jesus' name.
And
laws that are coming to some of the families, and they are bringing fire into the family, and your husband cannot talk amicably with the wife anymore, and the wife cannot be submissive anymore.
There's
fire burning in the family of this individual. Oh Lord, tonight we put it off in Jesus' name. Oh Lord, I pray that all your children that are here, and the devil has been waging war against them, and it appears they are saying, oh, how weak I am, how weak I am, I pray their weakness will be turned into strength tonight in Jesus' name. There will be failure in the day of battle. They will rise up in the arms of faith, they will put to fight the armies of the aliens, and Everything that have been intimidating them before, I pray that they be courageous from now on in Jesus' name. I pray that everyone here tonight, everyone that will listen to this message, this strong faith, this dynamic faith, this faith that cannot be denied, this faith that will shake every, that will remove every mountain, you grant it to everyone in Jesus' name. I pray that all your children will be overcomers.
They
will be more than conquerors. They will realize that greater is he that lives in them than he that's in the world, in Jesus' name.
The Lord grant
everyone complete security, complete protection, and perfect provision. I pray, oh Lord, they will not be weak again. They will not move back again. They will move forward in Jesus' name. They will be going from strength unto strength, from grace unto grace, from glory unto glory. All these exploits of faith, all these spectacular acts of faith, all these achievements of faith that we are really about tonight, you will transfer each into the lives and the families of every individual in Jesus' name. Oh Lord, I pray the testimony that you have given us through these people, that testimony will come into every life. Fill our hearts and lives with your goodness. Fill our mouths with joy and laughter. And your people will never be ashamed again. Thank you, Lord, because I know you have answered. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord and God bless you.